We want to write the equation of the circle in standard form and then give the center and radius of the circle. The given equation is in general form, and we know it's a circle because the coefficient of the x squared term and the coefficient of the y squared term are the same. In this case, they're both 1. We want to write this equation in standard form of a circle, which is this form here. Once we have the equation in this form, the center will have coordinates hk, and the radius will be equal to r. So looking at standard form, notice how we have a perfect square trinomial in terms of x and in terms of y, so we'll have to complete the square on the x part and y part of our equation in general form. So to set this up, let's go ahead and write x squared plus 5x. We're going to complete the square here, so we'll have to add a constant. So we'll put plus our constant here, then we'll have the y part, so we'll have plus y squared minus, I'm going to write this as minus 1y plus a constant, which will make this a perfect square trinomial. Let's go ahead and add 6 to both sides to move the constant to the right, so we'll have equals positive 6. Again, because we're adding two constants on the left side, we'll have to add two constants on the right side as well. This will help to remind us. Now to complete the square on the x part, we're going to take half of the coefficient of x and square it. It's important to show this work, and I'll show why in the next step. So we're going to take half of 5, which would be 5 divided by 2, and then square it. So we're going to square the top and square the bottom. That'll be 25 fourths. So we're going to add 25 fourths here, as well as on the right side. Now it's hard to tell, but this is now a perfect square trinomial. And then for the y part, we'll take half of the coefficient of y and square it. So we'd have negative 1 divided by 2 squared, which would be positive 1/4. Which means to complete the square, we'll add 1/4 here and add 1/4 here. Now again, it's hard to tell, but this trinomial in terms of x and this trinomial in terms of y are perfect square trinomials. So let's go ahead and factor them. They'll both factor into two binomials. So we'll have two binomials here plus two binomials here, and then we'll have this sum on the right side. So looking at the trinomial in terms of x, we'll have x and x. We want the factors of 25 fourths that add to 5. This is why it's so important to show this work here. The factors that we're looking for are 5 halves and 5 halves, the number that we squared in order to get this constant to make it a perfect square trinomial. So we'll have plus 5 halves here and plus 5 halves here. Now looking at the y part, we'll have y and y. And now we want the factors of 1/4 that add to negative 1. And the factors will be the number we squared to get the 1/4, which will be negative 1/2 and negative 1/2. So we'll have minus 1/2 here and minus 1/2 here. Notice if we didn't show this work here in red, it would be much more difficult to find the factors that we need. But notice in both cases, these are perfect square trinomials. And now on the right side of the equation, we have 6 plus 25 fourths plus 1/4. Well, 25 fourths plus 1/4 would be 26 fourths, which would simplify to 13 halves. These are both divisible by 2. So this is actually 6 over 1 plus 13 halves. The common denominator would be 2, so multiply this by 2 over 2. So now we have 12 halves plus 13 halves, so the sum would be 25 halves. And now we can go ahead and write this in standard form. We'll have the quantity x plus 5 halves squared plus the quantity y minus 1/2 squared equals 25 halves. So in this form, we can now determine the coordinates of the center and the length of the radius. Since we have the quantity x plus 5/2 squared, the x coordinate of the center would be negative 5/2. And because we have the quantity y minus 1/2 squared, the y coordinate is positive 1/2. And then to find the radius, 25/2 is equal to r squared. So if r squared equals 25/2, We know r has to be positive because it's a length. We could take the principal square root of both sides of the equation, or the positive square root. This would give us r equals the square root of 25 divided by the square root of 2, which is 5 divided by square root 2, which is the exact length of the radius. But let's go ahead and rationalize this. We would have 5 divided by square root 2. So to rationalize this, we'd multiply both the numerator and denominator by square root 2. So we would have 5 square root 2 divided by 2. So the exact length of the radius would be 5 square root 2 divided by 2. We're not required to rationalize, we can just give 5 divided by square root 2. But if we're going to use this to graph, decimal approximation will be more useful, which would be approximately 3.54. So we have a center with coordinates negative 5 halves, 1 half, and a radius that's approximately 3.54. So here's the information the problem required us to give. Let's go and take a look at the graph of this as well. This black point is our center with coordinates negative 5 halves or negative 2.5, 1 half. And if we sketch the radius or a segment from the center to any point on the circle, let's say this segment here, it would have a length of 5 square root 2 divided by 2, which again is approximately 3.54. Okay, hope you found this explanation helpful.